कॉन्टेक्ट में।
हाँ
चेतन
गगन
नोटबुक
क्लास
में।
ना। सरी बिड़ी ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯವಾದ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರು ಅಟೆಂಡ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿ, ಅಟೆಂಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಹುಷಾರಿಲ್ಲ, ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇದೆ, ಫೀವರ್ ಗಿವರ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಸರ್ಟಿಫಿಕೇಟ್.
ಓಕೆ
ವೆದರ್ ದಟ್ ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆಯಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ನನ್ಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ಬೋದಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ನೌ ಯುವರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಒನ್, ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಟೂ?
ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಒನ್.
ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಒನ್. ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ನೋ? ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ಹೌ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಒನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ಡ್ ಪಿಪಿಟಿ, ಸೊ ಯು ಯು ಅದರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ಅದರ್ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ತ್ರೀ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಟೂ ತ್ರೀ ಫೋರ್, ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರಿಂಗ್ ಪಿಪಿಟಿ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ ಟೈಟಲ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಫಾರ್ ಟುಡೇಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಯು ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಸಮ್ ಅಸೆಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಿಪಿಟಿ ಇವನ್ ಐ ಡಿ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನಾವು ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಗವಿ ಸಿದ್ದೇಶ್?
ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್.
ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂತ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪಿಪಿಟಿನಲ್ಲಿ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪಿಪಿಟಿಯಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಮಾಡರೇಟ್ ದ ಗ್ರೂಪ್?
ದೀಕ್ಷಿತಾ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಹಾ ಹೂ ದೀಕ್ಷಿತಾ. ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಐ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಒನ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಯುವರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಆನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಯೂತ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸಿಲೆಬಸ್, ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್. ದೋಸ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಆನ್ ಯುವರ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ. ಸೊ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ನೋ ದ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಆನ್ ದ ವಿಡಿಯೋ.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Deekshita MP, first year BSc Agriculture and same section as yours. Our topic is understanding youth and our group members are Chetan R, Deekshita MP, Dilip Kumar C, Divyashri SN, Gagan SM, Gagana S, Gavi Siddesh Patil, Govardhan Gowda MR, Gautami M, Gautami Narayana Swami, Gautami Niranjan, Harsha S, Imran and Veeresh. So in that I have chosen the subtopics definition of youth and profile of youth. So now let's see what is the definition of youth. What is meant by youth? How can you define youth, or what are the definition of youth? When I ask you these questions, one or the other answer will pop up in your mind, and each one of you will have your own answers because every individual have their own way of perspective of viewing the same things. Similarly,
just a minute, Deekshita, just a minute.
Yes, ma'am.
And Dilip, you are hosting, no? Are you recording this?
No, ma'am, I'm not recording this.
Is it possible for you to record?
No, ma'am, I have done. I don't have that option.
You don't
keen,
have that
keen
option.
Keen will record, ma'am. Keen, ma'am. Keen will record.
ಯುವರ್ ನೇಮ್ 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 ಯು ಆರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಎ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಒನ್. Then your ID number, you are ICR student, you are in a group one or other group? So you are recording for
group,
you are recording for this today's presentation? Okay, you can record and send it to me. Okay. Okay, you can continue, Dikshita.
Yes, ma'am. In the topic understanding youth, I have chosen the subtopics definitions of youth and profile of youth. So, what is meant by youth? How can you define youth? Or what is the definition of youth? When I ask you these questions, one or the other answer will pop up in your mind. And each one will have their own answers because every individual have their own way of perspective of viewing the same things. Similarly, youth can be defined generally, and also United Nations have given a standardized definition for youth, as we have a confined definition for health, which was given by World Health Organization. So now let's see, what is the general definition of youth? Around the world, the English terms youth, adolescent, teenager, kid, and young person are interchanged often, meaning the same thing, but they're occasionally differentiated. Youth can be referred to as the time of life when one is young. Youth is best understood as the period of transition from the dependence of childhood to adulthood's independence. Here, the line dependence of childhood to adulthood's independence. When I was searching for the
not audible, Dikshita.
Can
everyone else hear?
Yes, ma'am. It is audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Audible. It is audible.
Audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
For me now it is audible. For some moment I was not hearing Dikshita's voice.
No, ma'am.
And now it's I am hearing.
Okay, ma'am. Shall I continue?
Yeah. Continue.
Youth is best understood as the period of transition from the dependence of childhood to adulthood's independence. Here the line, dependence of childhood to adulthood's independence. When I was searching for the definition of youth, I found this sentence was quite interesting. Dependence of childhood to adulthood's independence. Well, now I want to pose you a question. Are we independent? No. Let me put it in this way. Are we truly independent? Are we still existing behind the bars of others' thoughts? I'm not pointing on anyone here. I'm just asking generally, are we independent? Yes, some of us are independent. Some of us are dependent on parents, friends, neighbors, fellow colleagues, etc., etc. Now, here I want to unfold a meme, which I expect that this may tickle your funny bone. The next slide. The dumbest thing I ever believed as a child was, once I'm grown up, I don't have to take permission from parents. Everyone would have surely thought about this name in their childhood. When we were still young, when our cheeks were still chubby, when we still fumbled to walk, when we were still mischievous and immature, everyone would have surely thought about this meme regarding breaking of this vampire permission. I'm not sure it is 100% true for all, but I'm sure that it is 50% true for the 50% of the girls. So, let's get back to the topic. Yet, age is the easiest way to define this group, particularly in relation to education and employment, because youth is often referred to a person between the ages of leaving compulsory education and finding their first job. Now, United Nations have given a standardized definition for youth, and that is youth are as those persons between age of 15 to 24 years with all United Nations statistics based on this range. The United Nations states education as a source of these statistics. Now, the conclusion of this definition is definition of youth perhaps changes with circumstances, especially with changes in demographic, financial, economic, and socio-cultural settings. However, the definition that uses 15 to 24 age cohort as youth fairly young people and providing guidelines for youth development. And now the next topic is the profile of youth. So, what is meant by profile? Profile is nothing but an outline of something or a person's description. I know that we all are well versed with Instagram, right? I can't say all of us, but most of us use Instagram, right? In that, whatever we write the Instagram Insta bio, which includes date of birth or our favorite person or our favorite dish or our favorite color and everything, it is nothing but a profile. So I can't say the words, ma'am.
Who is doing this? Who is doing this? Gavi Siddesh, nodta idira?
Yes, ma'am.
Yar maadta irodu? ಅಲ್ಲ ಯಾರು ಮಾಡಿರೋದು ಹೇಳಿ, ಅವನ್ಗೆ ಆಬ್ಸೆಂಟ್ ಆಗ್ತೀನಿ ಇವತ್ತು. ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇರ್ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್?
ಯಾರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗತ್ತಲ್ಲ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ?
ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಿಲ್ಲ.
ದಿಲೀಪ್ ಇವಾಗ ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡು ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್.
ಓಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ.
ಅದು ಮಾರ್ಕರ್ದು ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ತೆಗಿ ದಿಲೀಪ್.
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಅದು ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಡಿ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಪೆನ್ದು
ಪೆನ್ ಅದು ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡು ದಿಲೀಪ್. ಡಿಲೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಪೆನ್. ಸರಿ
ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಅ ನೈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಶನ್ ವಾಸ್ ಇನಿಶಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಡಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಸಚ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್? ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್?
ನಮ್ಮದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಿಲ್ವಾ? ಓಕೆ
ದಿಲೀಪ್, ಅದು ತೆಗ್ದಿದ್ಯಾ ಪೆನ್? ತೆಗ್ದಿದ್ಯಾ?
ಇಲ್ಲ ತೆಗ್ದಿಲ್ಲ.
ಅದು ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ನೋಡು, ತೆಗಿ.
ದಿಲೀಪ್ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಅನೋಟೇಟ್ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು.
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ದಿಲೀಪ್ ನನ್ನ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡು.
ಆಯ್ತು ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್
ನಾ ಒಳ್ಳಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ.
ರಿಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆಗಿ ನೋಡು.
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಇವಾಗ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್?
ಹಾ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಗೌತಮಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೀಮ್.
ಪ್ರೊಫೈಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯೂತ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್
ಬರೇ ದೀಕ್ಷಿತಾ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರೋದಾ, ಬೇರೆ ಗರ್ಲ್ಸ್ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ?
ನೋ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ಸ್ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಆಯ್ತು, ಅದ್ ಯಾವ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾದ್ರೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇರಿ ಹಾಗೆ.
So the next topic is profile of youth. As per the census 2011, youth population in India accounted to 22,38,05,788, of which 51.8% belongs to male and 48.13% belongs to female. Majority of the youth, that is 37.49%, belongs to the age group of 15 to 19. Minority of the youth, that is 29.51%, belongs to the age group of 25 to 29. As per India Census 2011, youth from 15 to 24 years in India constitutes 1/5 of India's total population. India is expected to have 34.33% share of youth in total population by 2020. Now here is Gautami M to talk about the categories of youth and issues and opportunities of youth. Thank you.
Very good initiation by Dikshita.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Dikshita. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Gautami M, and I will be taking over from here. Here is the next topic, youth categories. The World Health Organization outlines three different categories of the youth: adolescents, youth, and young people.
Dikshita, where is your video? I mean, Gautami, can you switch on your video?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Adolescence includes the group of people of age between 10 to 19 years. This critical development period is conventionally understood as the years between the onset of mind and the establishment of social independence. Adolescence can also be divided into three groups again: early adolescence of 10 to 13 years, mid adolescence of 14 to 15 years, and later adolescence of 16 to 19 years. The second one is the youth. Youth is the period between childhood and adult age. The individual with age between 15 to 24 years are referred to as youth. The last one is the young people. Young people are the one who are in between 10 to 24 years. Apart of these three categories, there is another one category, special category, which is known as teenagers group. It is between 13 to 19 years old, to which we also belong to. The next topic is issues and challenges of the youth. These issues and challenges of youth are mainly caused due to the society, and some of the main reasons for this are given here. Our world is changing in a rapid pace. Our today's society is completely different from how it was a decade ago. The problems of today are more influenced by people and the social problems than anything else, as an individual is mainly concerned with society's words rather than themselves, and the young people are mostly influenced to the negativeness than the positiveness. The next one is the communication gap. The communication gap being the most prominent between the youth of today and their elders. Now the youth has changed their mindsets. The conversation with parents changing dramatically unless they are well disciplined. Today's youngsters are pretty outclassed, means behaving are so possessive and excel as decisive themselves. But entering to the new period, people are beginning to realize and recognize serious concerns that our youth has to face today. Some of these issues and challenges are from a long time and may be continued in the future also. Some issues arise as a result of the change in the trends of this fast-paced life. Now let us see some of the main issues and challenges of the youth. These are the main issues and challenges of the youth. They are academic pressure, peer pressure, depression, bullying, raised by single parent, parental pressure, physical image, drug and alcohol abuse, lack of quality education, juvenile delinquency, poverty, inadequate employment opportunities, obesity and other health problems, materialism, maturity at young age. Now, I request one of my friends to continue from here and explain these issues. Thank you.
Good presentation by Gautami. So she was the one who was from yesterday she was very keen about this presentation. So actually good appreciation for her today.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, you can continue.
Dikshita, yaar dido academic pressure?
Divyashree SN.
Divyashree SN.
Good afternoon, one and all. Myself, Divyashree SN. My topic is academic pressure. Academic pressure is formally defined as an experience in which a student is burdened by the demands of time and energy to achieve specific academic goals. This stress can come from a variety of potential sources and have many impacts on students both emotionally and academically. Excessive level of this academic stress leads to physical problems like depression, nervousness, and stress-related disorders, which in turn affect their academic results. Academic pressure could be self-imposed, family-imposed, or imposed by society. It can be a positive force causing the student to want to do well, or it can be a negative force causing concentration problems in students while studying. Students in college experience higher perceived level of this academic stress are more likely to lower their academic achievement. According to the International Journal of Adolescents and Youth. Thank you, everyone.
Your name? Just now you presented, no? Your name?
Divyashree SN, ma'am.
Divyashree. Okay, good presentation.
Thank you, ma'am.
Hello, good afternoon, everybody. Myself, Arsha. I'm presenting the topic parental pressure. Parental pressure leads to stress and anxiety. This often causes parents to think they need to monitor their child's progress, preferably by intruding into their social life and peering over their shoulders while they study. Such high expectation and pressure may also cause the child to suffer blood pressure problems. Thank you. Next, my friend will continue.
Good afternoon, my friends. Myself, Ravishi Desh Patil, and I am from A section. Today's my topic is depression. I don't talk much about depression. I want to talk reason behind the depression. Friends, what is the most one-lettered selfish word? The most selfish one-lettered word is I, isn't it? Everything revolves around us, I. What does I stands for? I stands for my expectation. I should be treated like this. I should be respected like this. I should be loved like this. All are expectations. We are living a life of super high expectation, not just super high expectations. The constantly life is only all everything revolves around my opinions, my desires, my likes, my dislikes. I don't like this. I like this. I. You think life will be happy life when it revolves around I? From our childhood, we learn this. We only think that in our way of mind. So we always holding our opinions and expectations, and you are thinking religion is spared, if youngsters are not spared, if girlfriend boyfriends are not spared, if married peoples are not spared, you think religion men and religion peoples coming to the temple are spared for I don't think so. Therefore, when people comes to the God and people comes to the temple, also they are only asking, give me what I want. No one asks, comes and say, I love you, I want to give you. When the president of United States, John F. Kennedy, came up to the stage for his first presidential speech. His voice rumbled into the public and addresses the man. He said, ask not what country can do for you, ask what you can do for the country. In the same way, ask not what God can do for you, ask what you can do for a God. No one asks that because the I is so big, my expectations, my desires, my things are so powerful that even when I come to a temple and ring a bell, I am doing is only asking. The more we led a life of I, and I will remain frustrated because people do not exist in this world for just fulfill my expectations. And another thing, do not ever give the control of how you feel to the someone else. Do not allow anyone to control you. The TV can be controlled, the car can be remote controlled, but do not allow anyone to control your emotion from there. We give more importance to our expectations. When it doesn't happen, we feel frustrated, which leads to depression. So the most selfish one lettered word is I, which can be avoided by helping others. Be realistic in your expectations, but every time everyone will not satisfy your expectations. Avoid this one word by trying to serve others, because if you want to be served, you are dependent on the people. They may not serve you, but when you want to serve, who can stop you? People may not respect you, but when you want to give respect, who can stop you? People may not love you, but when you want to give love, who can stop you? So therefore, we should learn to begin our journey from I to you. The more you want for yourself, you remain frustrated. The more you want to give, you remain happy. So friends, in the title of our youth, in the word of youth, there is you, means we should serve our country in this age only. So, and I want to end this my presentation by saying our Gavimata Swamiji avardu ond naalak line heli idanna mugisakke ishta padtini. Bhoomi mele yar doddor aagtarandre ದೊಡ್ಡ ಮನಿ ಇದ್ದವ್ರು ದೊಡ್ಡವರಾಗಲ್ಲ, ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕುರ್ಚೆ ಮೇಲೆ ಕುಂತಾರ ದೊಡ್ಡವರಾಗಲ್ಲ, ದೊಡ್ಡ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ದುಡ್ಡು ಇರೋರು ದೊಡ್ಡವರಾಗಲ್ಲ, ದೊಡ್ಡ ಮನಸ್ಸಿದ್ದವ್ರು ದೊಡ್ಡವರಾಗ್ತಾರೆ. ದೊಡ್ಡ ಮನಸ್ಸಿರ್ಬೇಕು, ಆ ಮನಸ್ಸೊಳಗೆ ಖುಷಿ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಅವಾಗ ಮಾತ್ರ ದೊಡ್ಡವರಾಗೋದು. ಯಾವಾಗ ನಮ್ಮೊಳಗೆ ಖುಷಿ ಇರುತ್ತೋ ಅವಾಗ ಈ ಡಿಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಇರಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಬೈ ದಿಸ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಎಂಡ್ ಮೈ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಟು ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಸಚ್ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಅಪಾರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
Good presentation by Gavi Siddhesh, and even in NSS also your motto is not me but you. Okay, it is you are working for others. Okay, the motto itself is not me but you, even that is there.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, you can continue.
Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Gautami Niranjan. My topic is about teen pressure, peer pressure. Youth faces a lot of pressure from peer. Teens from different generations have faced peer pressure problems. However, the threat it poses today is different from how it was a few decades ago. Peer pressure is the direct influence on people by peers or the effect on Gautami, individual.
Yeah, just a minute. Same Gautami or another student?
Gautami Niranjan.
Another ma'am.
Because I don't know, no faces, you have to switch on your video so that I can mark it.
Shall I continue, ma'am?
Continue with your video. I'm just taking screenshot.
Yes. Peer pressure is the direct influence on people by peers or the effect on an individual who is encouraged and wants to follow their peers by changing their attitudes, values, or behaviors to conform to those of the influencing group or individual. For example, he or she started consuming alcohol in high school because of peer pressure. Technology and indulgence in social media take it to a whole new level. One can get so much exposure to another person's life that it could automatically put a lot of peer pressure. Ultimately, the solution for this peer pressure is that parents can help the children resist peer pressure by educating kids more about making healthy choices and tell them to take it as positive. Give them the confidence that your children can come up and seek your assistance if they are in trouble. By this, I end my presentation. Over to Dilip.
Once you switch on your video, I am now, just a minute. Hold that slide, peer pressure. I will take screenshot. Okay, so peer pressure you had during your high school
and now also youth.
Okay, you can continue.
I finished, ma'am.
Good afternoon, everyone. My topic is drug and alcohol abuse. Use and abuse of drugs and alcohol by teens is very common and can have a serious consequences. In the 15-24 year age range,
student, can you introduce yourself? Who is this?
Yeah, ma'am, I'm Dilip, ma'am. Myself.
Dilip. Oh, Dilip, you are the main person who has hosted for today's presentation also. No? Can you switch on your video? I want to see who is this.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, continue, yes. Dilip.
Okay, ma'am. More than 50% of the deaths involve alcohol or drug abuse. Also, the number of suicides due to drug and alcohol abuse addiction have more than doubled in the last 10 years. More than 95% of those committed suicides with this cause were male. But what is important is, prior to 2014, the gender categorization of victims was provided only as male and female. From 2014, the transgender is also included in the categorization of the victims. We have known that in most of these cases, the Maharashtra will be highest. So the Maharashtra has the highest number of recorded suicides due to this cause. Though Maharashtra maintains the top position, what is significant is the increase in this number of such cases is found in Karnataka also. See, in both 2018 and 19, Karnataka reported the second highest number of cases, overtaking Madhya Pradesh and Tamil Nadu, which have alternated for the second position. Also, the important thing is, only around 1/5 of the total suicides due to the drug and alcohol abuse are recorded in the major urban cities. What I actually mean is, suicides due to drug and alcohol abuse are higher outside the mega cities. A trend which is clearly noticeable is that, contrary to the popular perception that suicides due to drug abuse are widespread in the mega cities, data indicates the opposite. More than 80% of the suicides due to drug abuse are reported outside the mega cities. Even in case of Maharashtra, which has the highest number of such suicides, the number arising from Mumbai. Furthermore, the data in the accidental deaths and suicides in India's report is only about the suicides, which are caused due to drug abuse and alcohol addiction. The proportion of people who actually are indulging in drug abuse could be much higher, and their trend along with distribution might vary. However, such data is not readily available. But if we talk about the consequences, why these causes, why this drug and alcohol abuse are started, the possible status in experiences with alcohol and drugs include abstinence, regular use, and dependency. So,
ಪ್ರಧಾನಿ ಸೂಚನೆಗಾಗಿ ಕಾದಿರುವಂತಹ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿ
Dilip, continue.
The question is just because of curiosity. I mean, for adventure and excitement.
Yes, by luck.
Dilip, why is break up here?
He cares, sir. But the possible stages of teenage experience with alcohol and drugs include abstinence, experimentation, regular use, abuse, and dependency. Here, the experimentation is just because of the curiosity, need for adventure, and excitement. And this experimentation constitutes common causes which motivate youngsters towards the drug and alcohol abuse. A child's natural curiosity motivates him to experiment. This is complicated further by effects that might be perceived as benefits of alcohol or drug abuse. Thus, the first use of drug or alcohol abuse may be out of curiosity or experimentation. But later, the child starts using this to escape from facing problems. So here, we could analyze that it's not the drugs that make a drug addict. It's the need to escape reality. Of late, the stress from pressure to excel in academics or examinations has played a significant role in persuading the youngsters to try alcohol and drugs. The perception among the youth that it is cool or progressive to smoke, use drugs or alcohol is also in a way a major cause for youth to start these habits. In fact, the televisions, movies, newspapers, internet also help to promote this perception. A typical example for this is in a recent movie, an actor says, "Tumba olleyaragirbedro, solpa kettavaragi, nanu ketton admele uddaragiddu, gotalva." And these words are much more influenced by people than other things. Also, the other factors that have been seen to be associated with drug and alcohol abuse among adolescents are unstable or unsupportive family structures and peer pressure. So in this regard, the parents and the teachers have a special responsibility. Parenting that combines with high levels of nurturance and consistent discipline has been associated with lower risk of substance abuse. So now if we talk about the preventive measures, avoid undue peer pressure. What I mean is every child has his own choice and personality, which should be respected and nurtured. A child should not be pushed unduly to perform beyond his threshold limits, be it studies, sports, or other activities. And the next main important thing is education and counseling, obviously. Educating and counseling him to face problems and stresses and to accept disappointments and failures as a part of life. It would also be worthwhile to channelize the child's energy into healthy pursuits, like sports, reading, music, yoga, and other extracurricular activities. And the easiest method what we can take is the seeking help from parents and peers. Help from parents and peers should be sought immediately so that they can guide appropriately. Help may even be sought from close and trusted friends. Actually, this was followed by our beloved celebrity Sanjay Dutt. Once he took a drug and he was unconscious for almost 2 days. He realized that only when his servant said that he was unconscious for 2 days. So he made up his mind to leave the drugs and he went to his father at the 7 a.m. and asked him that I am addicted to drug. And his father Sunil Dutt reacted to this and took him to rehabilitation center in UK, and he was nearly 2 years there. And it was even his willingness to leave the drugs which he had overcome. And the important things which the people around have to looking for danger signs. I mean, alert parents and teachers need to look for and identify the danger signs. Even friends, if they find someone who using drugs or alcohol, should not hesitate to bring this to the notice of the parents or teachers in the best interest of the person concerned. So if all these measures failed, the only thing left is seeking professional and medical help. A lot of help is available in the form of highly qualified psychologists, psychiatrists, and de-addiction and rehabilitation programs to help individual who have unfortunately got in the quagmire of the drug or alcohol abuse. With such help, the affected individual with sufficient efforts and willpower can get rid of the problem completely and lead a perfectly normal and healthy life. So friends, what I suggest is just be young, wild and drug free. Thank you. Now, Imran will continue the topic with inadequate employment opportunities. Thank you,
ma'am. Good presentation by Dilip. Okay. So all this drug, alcohol, cigarette smoking, everything is external. It is nothing. It is just a fancy thing what you are seeing. Okay. It destroys you. Whatever organs you are having, no? So you are having very good throat, lungs, you are having everything, tongue, everything is gifted. All body parts are gifted by God. Okay. Why you want to spoil those body parts? Is it or not? Okay. So instead of a smoking habit is there. Okay. So there's gradually it will spoil tongue, it will spoil lungs. It will, you can see that you will not be having the taste of normal foods also if they are chain smokers and all. So that's why to adopt all such bad habits in your life? Better to say no for all such bad habits. Is it or not? So along with drug and alcohol, even smoking will also be added. Smoking, chewing tobacco and all. And if you see the statistics, 1/3 of the deaths in India is due to cancer only. And that too, it is due to tobacco chewing, smoking and all these alcohol abuse. Okay, so that I just wanted to add along with this slide. Okay, you can continue.
Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Imran. My subtopic is inadequate employment opportunities.
Where is your video? I don't know who is Imran.
Yes, madam.
Okay.
Inadequate means lacking something or something.
Just switch on your video and speak. No, I am taking a screenshot.
Yes, madam.
Yeah, you can
let's
speak.
See why.
For a while.
Okay, continue.
Let's see why youths are lacking for employment. Until a few decades ago, only people who really had the knack for education pursued it. In today's time, it is totally different. People want to achieve better and higher academic credentials, not only to gain a certain status, but also grab better employment opportunities with fully fledged facilities. A simple high school pass out or a college graduate today may not find enough opportunity to live contentedly. The pressure of earning better and superior degrees one after the other is growing, just to say they can stay competitive enough in the market. The youth today needs more than just a college degree to survive with good pay to afford a decent living. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, there are so many degree holders in India. Imran, so there are so many degree holders in India. And majority of the population, like 60% of the population is only youth. Okay, yes. Just having degree, they are not, there is so much unemployment. Is it or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Just with degree, it is very difficult to survive with degree or with MSc or with PhD. So lots of young population is unemployed. Have you collected information about that? First group?
No, ma'am, not.
Okay. So you can add on one slide related to that also. Okay. What is the status and statistics of youth unemployment? Okay. That is also very important. So Imran would have added some more information like the previous presenters. Anyhow, you can collect and you can just maybe in next class, you can just give the information. Is it okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, you can continue now.
Good afternoon to one and all. Myself Gagana. I am glad to present about National Youth Day. This presentation would be incomplete without speaking about Swami Vivekananda. National Youth Day, also known as Vivekananda Jayanti.
Your name?
Gagana, ma'am.
Yes, can I know your name? Gagana, okay. Okay, continue.
National Youth Day, also known as Vivekananda Jayanti, celebrated on 12th January, being the birthday of Swami Vivekananda. In 1984, the Government of India declared this day as the National Youth Day, and since 1985, the event is celebrated in India every year. The Government of India quoted the philosophy of Swami Vivekananda, and the ideals for which he lived and worked could be a great source of inspiration for Indian Youth Day. The National Youth Day is observed all over India at schools and colleges with processions, speeches, music, youth conventions, seminars, yogasanas, presentations, competitions in essay writing, recitations and sports on 12th January every year. Swami Vivekananda's lectures and writings, deriving their inspiration from Indian spiritual tradition and the broad outlook of his master Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, these were the source of inspiration and have motivated numerous youth organizations, study circle and service projects involving the youth. Now I would like to quote some of Swami Vivekananda's quotes which inspires every youth. Take risks in your life. If you win, you may lead. If you lose, you may guide. Arise awake and stop not until the goal is reached. Talk to yourself once in a day, and otherwise you may miss meeting an excellent person in this world. Now I request Gautami Narayan Swami to conclude this presentation.
Good information by Gagana.
Thank you, ma'am.
In your high school, were you reading all these Vivekananda's books and preachers? Anybody?
Gautami Narayan Swami, can you continue?
Slide. Good afternoon, everybody.
Yes,
good afternoon, everybody.
Your name?
Ma'am, Gautami. Gautami,
okay.
Ma'am.
Okay.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Gautami. By their pretty eyes in the total population, we can see that youth are the country. We can get the figures of Indian youth on the screen, youth population on the screen. It not only works good to India, but also to the entire world. So our contribution to country and world is very much required. We could know the reason for the problems of many youth and also their opportunities till now. But there are several problems which we create for ourselves, which have to be realized by all of us. There are fights between youth for ideology. We create communal riots, religious conflicts. We indulge in many anti-national activities. We not being honest, being corrupted in our work, drag the country down from progress. We do not inculcate tolerance towards other religions and communities. We try to hide our capabilities. We still believe in superstitions. We won't be careful enough in choosing our representatives. We do not exercise our rights properly, and we do not follow our duties properly. We misread hatred and violence among ourselves. We, the youth of the country, our world, should essentially realize that this won't bring progress or prosperity to the country. If we do not change ourselves in these aspects, the population of the country will essentially turn to a disaster. Country has realized the power of youth in 1970s itself, when students' agitations in the states of Bihar and Gujarat, which led to JP movement and national emergency in its later stages, which had long-lasting effects on the socio-political status of the country. But we should also realize that revolution cannot occur overnight. Though Swami Vivekananda's name spreaded after his participation at Chicago Conference for World Religion, he had to train himself under the guidance of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa for several years, and he had to travel throughout the country in strengthening his own thoughts and philosophies. But his participation at Chicago, which had speeded up Indian freedom struggle, and his thoughts, which still continue to motivate us. We have the great examples of our freedom fighters who entered freedom struggle at their young ages. So we shouldn't underrate our own path. Slide. Next slide. Next slide, please. We should involve ourselves in the process of society building in all the ways possible. We, the youth, have many innovative ideas for curbing the problems like unemployment. Many of us may become policy makers and lawmakers to change the existing policies which are not efficient for present situation. And we may form many good policies for the coming generation. But the only thing is that we should gain enough courage and come forward. We should have that zeal of giving back to the society. There is a figure on the screen, there is a statement on the screen stating that Indian labor force will grow by 8 million per annum from coming decade, which may be a challenge for policymakers and government to create sufficient employment opportunities. The competition among youth can become a major problem for this, a reason for this. I would like to quote a saying by famous philosopher Vidya Krishna Murthy: competition creates comparison, competition creates jealousy, competition creates sorrow, competition creates violence. For God's sake, don't compete. He also continues that competition do not bring about true learning. True learning occurs only when competitive spirit is seized. I personally believe that this statement is very true, because if we just compete to win, we may win. But if we compete among ourselves in learning and giving back to the society, we may win even, and we also succeed in our motive. So we should put our ideas for the integration of the society, not merely for gaining an employment or earning. So let's all of us try to put our ideas for integration of our society. Let's try to keep tiny steps towards this. For instance, our participation in NSS can be much meaningful if we do not merely participate just for formalities. Let all of us be enthusiastic in changing ourselves and in the society. Thank you, everybody, for patient listening. Thank you. Have a nice day.
And thank you, ma'am, for giving such a good opportunity.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, good efforts and good presentation by first group.
Headed by Devi Siddesh and
so congratulations to you all. So your participation is very much appreciated. So now in the similar manner, the other groups will also be presenting. So that at least we will have some NSS activity through online also. Is it or not, Devi Siddesh?
Yes, ma'am.
So on behalf of your class, I am asking you. So it will be good if we are having one or the other activity. I also appreciate if the other group will also do like this only, maybe in next class.
Chetan and group, ma'am.
Group number?
2, ma'am. Chetan and group.
Okay. Anyhow, all your names and ID numbers will be there. So that is the proof for me that you have done this presentation activity. Okay. The student who has scribbled on screen. Okay. So this is the last warning for you. You should not do like this. See, we are speaking on a very good topic, that is about youth, understanding youth. It's a very good topic and it is need of the hour. Okay. And if you do, how it is like you are deviating so many 92 students along with teacher, if you are scribbling on the screen, it is not a fair thing. Okay. Nobody came to know who has scribbled that, but you will be listening to me. So this is my last warning for you. If anybody does like that indecent behavior in class, you will be just given some action will be taken. Okay. So this is the first and last, and you should not do like that. Okay. See, I am having so many works. I have to prepare for so many classes and all. In spite of that, I have arranged one presentation for you people and you have done like that. It is not a good behavior what you have done. Okay. You will be listening my words. Okay. So this is not a good behavior. Don't repeat again. Don't repeat ever in life in other teachers' PPT also. Okay. So I will end here. So the next group, that is Chetan and group, will be presenting for the next class. So you also do like how the group one has done. So you coordinate with all your members and you send the finalized PPT and then you start presenting. Is it okay, Chetan and group?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so you mention all your ID numbers and everything will be recorded here. Okay, okay then.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, so thanks, now somebody ma'am. had recorded. Recording, no? Somebody is recording?
Yes, ma'am. Keen, ma'am. Keen.
Gavi Siddesh, you can collect from him and send to me.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, sure.
Okay. Okay. So monitor all those ಏನಾದ್ರು ಮಾಡೋರು ಇದ್ರೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನೀವು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರಿ. ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವೈಸ್. ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ 100% ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಡೂ, ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವೈಸ್ ಅಮಾಂಗ್ ದಮ್. ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ದೆನ್.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.